update. So let's get into it. It's been about a year and a half since my second cycle of Lemtrada. Lemtrada is the brand name of the human monoclonal antibody Alemtuzumab. And what Alemtuzumab does, in brief, is it destroys some of your T and B cells, which are thought to attack the central nervous system in persons with MS. So by depleting the body of those lymphocytes, you can, in a way, reset your immune system, and hopefully your new immune system doesn't behave in that way. Normally you would have two cycles of Lemtrada. Some go on to have third, fourth, and fifth cycles. So far, so good for me. I've only needed two cycles. And let's talk first about my lymphocyte count. Immediately after my second infusions, my lymphocyte count was zero. Well, almost zero. And today, my lymphocyte count is 1,300. So that means 1,300 lymphocytes in 1 microliter of blood. I really hope I've got that right. I don't have a medical background, but everything I know is purely from asking questions and doing my own research. So my lymphocyte count is relatively low, but now between the normal range for an adult. So the normal range for an adult is between 1,000 and 4,800 lymphocytes in 1 microliter of blood. Luckily for me, there has been no evidence of disease activity since I started treatment with Lemtrada. I'm one of the lucky ones, I guess. The medication is highly effective, and that's why I decided to take this path. I couldn't have hoped for a better outcome, and I'm grateful every day for the new lease of life that I've been given by this disease-modifying therapy. With the sweet also comes the sour. On the one hand, my MS has taken a back seat. There are some negatives to this, and it would be remiss of me to leave them out. I have been found to have hepatic adenoma, hopefully I'm saying that correctly. And what that is a benign liver tumour. There's no way of really knowing if it was caused by alemtuzumab because I've never had an ultrasound prior to having alemtuzumab. And I had the ultrasound because I was getting regular urinary tract infections, which is something that is quite typical for somebody who's had Lemtrada at least in the first year or so after infusions, because your immune system is so low. And I felt as if I was retaining urine, so my doctor suggested that I go for this assessment. What was discovered was this adenoma. So as I say, no way of really knowing that whether or not it formed after having alemtuzumab or not, but something to watch out for, I guess. Now, this is benign and it's quite common in women, so not something that I'm really worried about. Aside from that, I would say having passed the year mark, my UTIs have subsided. I think I've just gotten better at knowing how to prevent contracting UTIs. I really wish that I had filmed this video when I meant to about 2 months ago, because this wouldn't have been a topic. But I do think that the universe works in mysterious ways, and I was meant to film this video today so that I could include this, and that is that I now have shingles. Shingles is a reactivation of the varicella zoster virus, and that is basically chickenpox. So if you've ever had chickenpox, the virus never dies. It stays dormant in the body and can be later reactivated. So I do remember having my infusions, and at that time being told by my medical team that I needed to take 1 month's worth of acyclovir to prevent getting shingles. I didn't really understand fully what shingles would feel like, what it would be like, what the symptoms would be like initially. And where I associated taking the acyclovir immediately after having my infusions, I presumed naively that the shingles risk was really around about that time, like the initial stages of treatment. And I've gone about my business, my day-to-day life, and not even thought about the risk of contracting shingles at this stage at least. What I noticed about 2 weeks ago was some soreness under my left breast, and I just, again, naively presumed it was heat rash. But lo and behold, about 2 days after seeing the redness, it had developed into shingles. If I had perhaps had the idea of what it could have been and had gone to the hospital as soon as I noticed symptoms, maybe I could have nipped it in the bud very quickly. But I thought it was heat rash. Heat rash is something that I have had before, so it wasn't unreasonable that that's what I thought it was. The point is, the quicker you treat shingles, the more minor the outbreak will be and the less risk of long-term neuropathic pain. For me, I would say some discomfort left behind, but it's not unbearable. All I can say is I now know what to look out for moving forward, and hopefully, if you've had Lemtrada and you're watching this video, you will also have the reminder that shingles can affect you at any point, not just immediately after having infusions, and just so that you are aware that we are at increased risk of serious complications from contracting shingles. If you get shingles in your face or near the eye, it can cause blindness. So if you see any irritation, any rashes on the body, be very quick to go to your doctors. I won't take any chances now, and I will go straight to the doctors if I see any form of rash develop on my body. But anyway, this has been a longer video than anticipated. Thank you for watching all the way into the end. Please subscribe if you haven't done so already, and please like this video if it's been of any use to you. And please leave some comments down below as to what videos you'd like to see me create moving forwards. I'm really open to suggestions, and as much as I can help you, I will try to do my best. So take care until the next video, and stay safe.